6. Cover me.
Hi, and welcome back to part 2 of this Boomerang phaser build. Now, at the moment, I'm concentrating on the body parts, the three main body parts. And the trapdoor that goes underneath. So basically, those three go to make the body, and then it's got a black rubberized handle, the grip. So I'm about to give this its first coat of paint. But before I do that, it's had a coat of primer sprayed over it, and I used this. It's supposed to be green wet and dry, and it's foam backed, very thin foam, so it holds the moisture, but I use it dry. This is medium, and I just give it a quick, very gentle rub just to take the roughness. Off the primer. It's all very gentle, there's no pressure. Well, I've gone over everything with this. I then switch to, it's the same product, but this is preparation material. This is 3000 grit. It's very fine. And as you rub the parts, it actually almost polishes it. It does make it extremely smooth. So I do this for every part that I'm going to paint. Take your time, don't rush it. So I'm going to get on with this, and when I finish, we'll go down to the painting area. Now, while I'm sanding, or rubbing down, I should say, because this is very fine, the parts to be painted, the hole in this phaser nozzle is slightly too small to get the LED through, so it's inside the chamber. So what I'm going to use is a reamer. It's a prop reamer from a model aircraft. If you ever fly radio control aircraft or go to a model shop, you use these to enlarge the hole in the centre of a plastic prop. It's quite useful for getting into here and just reaming out very slowly to make the hole bigger from this end and not increase it from this end. That's why I like using a reamer, where a drill bit would drill this hole exactly the same size all the way through. And I test fit until I'm happy that this has gone in enough, and it hasn't yet. So I'm going to ream a bit more out. And I'm quite happy with that. The LED fits in quite nicely. It's sitting, you can't see it in there, so what I'm going to do is test it. So you can see that, I'll turn the lights down. Do that down there. So I think that's a pretty good position. So that's just about ready now to go and have a spray paint. Something I didn't mention is for drilling this hole, you'll notice there's a hole on this side that I started. I actually put the drill piece through here on the right hand side, and then I suddenly realized by looking at the grip, it's actually cut out here already, and I'm pretty sure that's cut out. So a wire can come through into the handle, And as you'll see, is when they go together, that's on the left hand side. So this is my main hole. You can see it's much bigger. I made it bigger to get both wires through. This was a pilot hole I drilled by error. I'm just going to fill that up now with a bit of fill. I'm going to try and fill this up. Give it one last sanding. I'll have to give it another coat of primer because of this. Sand it down again and then give it its first coat of paint. So as the Boomerang Fraser's body has got some filler on it and I'm waiting for that to dry, I thought I'd at least start on the nozzle. Now this is all being primed, as I said before. I've sanded it down, it's all nice and smooth. I've reamed it out at the back, so I'm happy where the LED fits. So all I need to do now is give it its first coat of paint. Now some people would hang this in a facility or outside if it's a nice summer's day and spray it all around. I don't have that luxury, and this is the way I do most of my spraying. So I just cover a table with newspaper, position the item so I can get to one side of it. Now I've seen these painted in gloss black and I don't like it. Paint it whatever colour you want. I don't care if it's not screen realistic. I'm going to use a satin black. So this is the Boomerang Fraser body. I've sanded it all down, filled in where I had to. Just got to push that out. The hole I made by error has been filled in. It wasn't really necessary, but I've done it. I'm going to put that in place as I spray it. So I use two colours. I'm using what's called a Polaris Grey and a Silky Silver. So it's been about an hour since I've put the first coat on. And it is only a first coat, so it'll all be rubbed down. But now what I've got to do is this on the back. This is all dry, so it's safe to hold it over. So here we are after a couple of sprays and rub downs. It's still not perfect, but it will do for now. So the nozzle fits. All I need to do now with this piece of the phaser is this slightly raised platform here where the buttons go. This needs to be black. So what I'll be doing, I'll be using masking tape to mask off, leaving this piece exposed, and then again using the satin black so they match up with the nozzle. I'll be spraying this part black. Well, I'm going to finish masking this off. And then we'll go and spray it. Okay. That's now ready to paint this bit satin black. I use a screwdriver gently to tap in the corners and the edges to make sure there's a good seal. Okay, it's pretty decent. go get it sprayed. Okay, so I'll leave that to dry for an hour. Then after that, I'll check it over, give it a rub down if necessary, just the black part. Reset some masking tape, give it another spray, leave it another hour, check it over, and then take the masking tape off. Well, I've finished spraying this black panel. And what I'm going to do now is remove all this masking tape. Okay, so that's basically the painting done. I do need to do a bit of touch up here and there. A little gap here, but I'll use a brush just to touch that bit up. And a little bit here, and again I'll use a brush just to touch that bit up, but the rest is okay, it's looking okay. Maybe just a little bits on those edges here. Well, that's basically the painting done. In part 3 we'll start installing the electronics. Thanks for watching.